Today we're going to talk about a setup that we had in the trading room in the queues, and it was a pretty simple symmetry setup. So here, one of the things that you can see is the most recent high to low on the left-hand side lasted for 4 trading days, and it was $3.03. Now I projected that from the most recent high made on April 5th. And that gives us a projection at 130.45. The actual low is made at 130.50. And this decline was $2.98. So very similar there. Now there's another projection from the left-hand side of this chart that is also very similar. And that projection came in underneath at 130.10. Beyond that, we had a 7.86 retracement of the prior low to high swing. So that was a symmetry setup that included a 7.86 retracement of the prior swing. We also had time symmetry, as these swings were exactly equal in time, 4 days down and 4 days down. So that was the setup. Now, as far as what the potential is, well, if we follow the path of least resistance, which is the pattern of higher highs and higher lows, then typically what we look for is the 1272 extension as the target. We don't always make targets, though, so you have to watch or, you know, trail up stops as you go, especially if you run into, let's see, resistance with the 618 retracement that might overlap another symmetrical projection. So an important hurdle on the way up is going to be this 132.34 to 132.42 area. If we can push through it, however, then expect the rally to continue with the initial upside target at 134.29. Now, how do you get involved in a trade like this? Well, I'm just going to give you an example of a day trading trigger. So this, I'm going to look at a 2-minute chart and show you what we typically look for. Now, here's where we made the low this morning. It was just within 5 cents of that key support that was close enough to look for trade triggers against it. And the signal that, you know, I typically look at is an 834 EMA crossover on a lower time frame chart. This is a 2-minute chart of the queues. And what I like to see is, you know, the moving average crossover in my favor, you know, of the trade. So I needed the 8 to cross above the 34. And I also want to see it take out a prior swing high, indicating a pattern shift from lower lows and lower highs to potentially higher highs and higher lows. Okay, so that's what we did see. When we at least took out this prior swing high, we also took out this prior swing high, and then you had the moving average crossover over here. So when both of those things occurred, you knew that it was okay to look at the buy side and to place a stop underneath this last low. Okay. Now, it didn't last all day long, okay, but it was worth some money. Now, as far as whether or not it's going to be good for the longer term, that's another story. But as long as we continue to hold above that last low, you can look at any new buy triggers that come in against that original setup, because ultimately, if we can clear this hurdle, we do have a much higher target. So you might be a little bit late to the party, but the party's not quite over.